Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and we are going to continue with making lapbook journal from old books, from coffee dyed paper, from coffee dyed envelopes, from anything, from any scraps we've got. And before we're gonna continue, I'm gonna share with you my shopping today. This is second time when I'm trying to take this video, and if it will be possible, I will put a piece of that previous video somewhere now. If it will be not possible, I will put that small piece like separate video, and you will see what was happened to me today. I took that video, I was taking that video with processing, and that construction right there, that shelving right there, which is holding my camera, just fell down. Everything was there just fell down. Everything was all around, all those metal filigrees, metal pieces was all over me. And it was surprised me, it was upset me. So I went shopping and I made myself small gifts to make me more happy. And I purchased this color for her. It's intense copper. It's like a really beautiful copper. So I'm gonna apply it tomorrow. Also, because I'm off with this, it's that blusher. I purchased this one. It is a soft blush with vitamin E. So hopefully it will be nice. And also, normally I don't have, you know, nails because my job, it's kind of weird, so my nails are not holding for a long time. But because tomorrow it's New Year's Eve, or day after is New Year's Eve, so I'm gonna make me a little bit pretty. So I purchased this one. I hope you will see that shimmer. It's beautiful burgundy color with shimmer inside. So hopefully it will look beautiful on my nails, even I don't have too long nails. I try to put it here, but oh, my lighting will make that color a little bit different, I believe. But it's a really nice color, so I will see. So I made shopping for myself. I'm gonna make me beautiful. So now we're gonna continue with making something with this. We start with that basic cover. And now I would like to have here on that basic cover some pockets, and I've got few amazing comments. I didn't check it today, so I have to go there and try to answer as much as I can from you guys. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. Thank you so much for help. I hope I will pronounce that right. Jibit, it's her name, one of my subscribers. She wrote me words which I was looking for in that previous video. That right now, I need a contrasting color. Thank you so much for this help. It's amazing that you are helping me with English language and with finding those right words, which I am lost in it. So, now I need some contrasting color. And I prepared myself a few brown envelopes. Disc envelopes. Pardon me. These coffee dyed envelopes, and also, this coffee dyed paper. Sometimes when I'm coffee dyeing, and at the summertime when I'm leaving my papers outside to let them dry, the sun makes that color much more darker. So this is one of these papers which went really dark, so I think I'm gonna use this for my next pocket, because it's not soft, it's fragile paper and it's long, so I'm gonna half it, I think like this, and then I'm gonna work with it like with my, yes, if I will make it half, not half, so I will fold it this down and glue it down, it will make this top edge a little bit stronger. So I'm gonna use some wet glue because I would like to make here some folder. I'm gonna glue all that down. So thank you so much for your amazing comments, and I'm so happy you like this lab book style, and I am so happy that I am not just alone who didn't hear about those books before, who is kind of newbie in lab books like I am, and I really love them. I think it's something so amazing. So I'm so glad that I'm not just on my own, who is like a newbie in this. So I made that this top a little bit stronger, and now I think, sorry for my breath, I think I would like to have there like small tap, maybe, probably yes, I'm not sure if I would like to have it in middle, or just small one. Here, this one, maybe I will do just small on the side, yeah, on this side I will do. So first I'm gonna score those lines where is end, where is our edge, like, you know, from which side to which side. Oh my god, my explanation will be really brilliant. I think I'm still in shock from that falling down of my construction over there. You know, everything today, it's somehow weird. It's 16 and a half, so I'm gonna take my scoring board. And yes, I did read that many of you have same board. I'm so happy. I hope you like it like I do, because it's really brilliant. So I'm gonna use this scoring board. And don't worry if you don't have any scoring board. I've been without scoring board for really long time. As you know, I'm crafting around, I think, in this scrapbooking I am about 4 years, and this is my first scoring board. Before I used only this one, and not first, no, I'm wrong. I had this one, this teeny mini baby. This is kind of scoring board as well, but I mean, large one. This is my first, and I've got it, I think, about 2 weeks. So don't worry if you don't have. Just take a ruler, then some tool which you're gonna use, like your scoring tool. The great tool for scoring, it's a knife, but with that not cutting side, but with that opposite side. It's brilliant scoring tool. So try to take this. I'm gonna use this one. And it was 16 and a half, which means that my page is 6.5 inches wide. So I'm gonna score this to 6.5. This is 8.5. Wow, so I'm gonna have deep edge. What I'm gonna do? Oh, I can do really deep pocket, because I've got a really big size of paper. My page is 6.5, and this paper is 8.5, so which means it's giving me 1 inch on both sides. So I'm gonna try to do it this way. I'm gonna score it half an inch, and half an inch again, like 1 inch, you know, half inch, 1 inch, and here on the end, again, 2 lines, it's half inch, half inch, and we will see. I'm gonna fold it like this, and like this, like accordion folding, and same, it will be on that other side, like this, and come on, like this. This will be my basic page, And now I'm going to create that tap. Maybe I can create the fold on the bottom, or maybe later. So now I'm gonna create the tap on the top. I'm gonna take one of my templates. Sorry for my head, I'm gonna be in the view again. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna create some tap. I think here. This is nice. Okay. I'm gonna create small tap here using my template. If you've got those brilliant tools like it's that envelope maker, just use it. You can use just a ruler, pen, and draw it down. Now I'm going to cut that down, cut it out, those pieces. Here. Here. Show me, show me, show me. And it will be like this. And I think it looks nice. And on the bottom, I will glue it with... I can score it first, but... Because that bottom part of that paper, it's a little bit... Not a little bit, it's very fragile. So I'm gonna... Placed first that double-sided tape, it will make it a little bit stronger. And now I just need to cut those pieces here because this will be folding down. So those pieces I can cut out. Them through the bin. Now I will fold it just where my double-sided tape is. And because my double-sided tape is half an inch, it means that I will have here half an inch fold. Here is half an inch as well. So I hope it will be okay. I'm gonna glue this using double-sided tape as well. And we will see. I know it's different way than we normally do or pockets, but I think it doesn't matter which process you're gonna use. That important is result which you're gonna end up. So even if you will use different type of tools or different type of that process, I think that important is if you are satisfied with your finished project. I'm gonna glue it down. I hope I am in view. Probably right now I'm not. And I think I glue it down wrong. Show me, show me, show me. Oh, no, it's okay. So we've got first pocket here. I hope you saw something that I'm not totally out of view. So we've got first pocket here. And I decide to not use so much distress ink in this one. Just here and there. And as you can see, because I folded twice here, that pocket, it's really nice and deep. So I've got one pocket and I think I will use something more here. So to make it easy, I can use those coin envelopes and glue it down. And I believe it will be beautiful, beautiful pocket, but I would like to have inside some some book page paper, and because this envelope has been coffee dyed, so those sides are not holding properly anymore. So I'm gonna open it. I'm gonna take some book page. I've got here this. This is a whole world stamp catalog, which is beautiful book for crafting. It's a really amazing book for crafting. So I'm gonna take one page. I'm gonna take all signature. Ah! Come on! Hit to me! I'm sorry! Chico just appeared right next to me. Don't do it. Come on.
Ruining books for no reason.
Hey, come on. You're always telling me that I've got too much here. Oh, mine. Okay, that was my son. My younger son. Okay. And we've got here some nice pictures. Oh, I like these pictures. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna put my glue here. Not glue. Double-sided tape. Here. I'm sorry for that shout. He totally surprised me. He likes to do this. Especially when I'm taking video. He loves to do that. I'm sorry for that. Thank you. Oh, it's my baby. Okay, now I'm gonna draw down kind of template of this envelope. Oops. Or not. I'm gonna draw down template of this envelope like this. Okay, look at the template. But because I don't want to have a full background with this, I have to cut it a little bit inside around that template. So it will give me smaller template than I draw. And hopefully it will be okay. I'm leaving gap between my drawing and between my fussy cutting around 1/8. Of inch, I think. Hopefully that will be enough. We will see. I will place it inside. Come on. Yes! That's exactly just here. Small piece. Side as well. Okay. And here I'm gonna use a little bit of black salt distress ink, just small amount, not too dark. And I'm gonna glue it down. I wanted to say something, but Jacob totally confused me. I'm sorry. He's horrible. Okay. So here we've got our envelope. Now I can glue down back those sides. And I hope you went to have a look to that it's a lab booking 101, also to that Kathy Orta's December daily. I know she's making it like a photo album, but that process and all what she made, it's totally amazing. So that's why I share it with you, because it's really, really beautiful, really gorgeous project she made. And I think I will glue this down as well, and I make it a little bit. Here is my A here. hier a little bit decorative. Yeah. So I really hope you went to have a look on those projects and on those pages. Because that labooking style, it's totally awesome. Awesome, awesome. And I'm so happy that you like that as well, that you're gonna try it as well. So here we will have this pocket. And I'm gonna glue it just on those two sides, which will give me another pocket behind that. So I'm gonna do it. You can also use glossing bags. You can make any kind of pocket from paper you want, from book pages. Okay. So it's this one. You can make pockets, I'm gonna show you. You can put there one flat pocket here, then a little bit deeper, like I made here, here, and then you can use glossing bag and make this pocket. This is a very easy pocket. I'm gonna show you. I'm not sure where I saw this type of pockets, but I'm gonna show you how you can make it. It's a really very easy pocket. I'm gonna take one paper. And I'm gonna make this pocket to fit this tag. This tag I cut out using Tim Holtz die. This is tag and book plates. Hopefully you will see that tag and book plates here. It's this type of die. Here are those shapes. Maybe you will see just a little bit of those shapes. those shapes. This and kind of this one, but it's not proper. It was just fault. This is half of that. This one and here. So I'm gonna use this tag. Oh no, I'm gonna make pocket for this tag. This tag. This tag is 3 1/8 wide. Hopefully it's right word. So I'm gonna make pocket for this tag. Okay, I'm gonna use this. Pardon me. I'm gonna use a piece of this of those book pages. I'm gonna cut this down in that middle. Oops. Aha. I think I stuck. Nope. Come on. For this folded envelope, this it's like double envelope, because this tag is 3 1/8, and I like to have those folds half an inch. It means that I need a piece of paper which is wide 4 1/8. I'm gonna cut it down. And I'm not gonna tell you how long paper, because there it's huge possibility for you to use even not too short, of course not too short, but even not too long paper to make this pocket. This paper, it's long 8.5 inches. This pocket, it's from two pockets, and for your eye it's nice when this gap between edges of those two pockets, it's about one inch or 1.5 inch. It's that beautiful view for your eyes. So when you've got paper which measure half, oh my god, 8.5, that good view for your eye will be when this end will be folded, will be ended on 7, like 1.5 inch under that edge, and it will be nice view for your eye. So I'm gonna make 1/2 inch here, 1/2 inch on that other side. I fold it that 1.5 inch under my edge of that paper, which is nice view for your eye. Now I'm going to do those side scoring lines. Half an inch, that other side, 1/2 inch as well. So we've got scoring line here. Oh, you can see that. We've got here scoring line where it will be folded. And now we're gonna cut from this edge to that scoring line, the corner, that scoring line, just a small notch. I think you call it that notch. Maybe I'm wrong, but I think you call it these notches. So you're gonna end up with something like this. And now what do you have to do? You're gonna fold these inside and these to bottom. And now you're gonna fold this up. And you've got your double pocket. It's very easy. So again, you've got template like this. You're gonna fold these on that smaller inside, these under, and now that small pocket you're gonna fold on that large pocket, and you've got beautiful double pocket. If you wanna have here that element cut, half circle cut, I was trying to do it this way, which kind of giving me chance that both pockets will have that cut at the same position. So I hold it both papers or both pockets like this. Then I put there my 1/2 inch. That I think this one, it's one inch circle punch. I place it kind in middle and cut. Whoa, good. And we've got, see, they are at same position, and you do it at same time, which make it much more easy. And now just glue your top small pocket to your large pocket using these folds. Glue it down. And glue using glue on those. This is our pocket, so put glue here on the bottom and here, and glue it on your page, and you will have beautiful double pocket for your text. Ah, it's still glued there. Sorry, it's. So you will have beautiful double pocket for your text, and I think I do it. Yeah, good. It's really very easy, and to give you measurement, it will be like just for one tag. So if you wanna do it for tag or for your photography, first take wideness of your photography or tag, how wide it is or deep it is. Then cut your paper a little bit. No, not little bit. Oh my god, I'm sorry. Cut your paper and wideness plus those folds. And then it doesn't matter how long it is. Just remember that nice for your eyes. It's 1 inch or 1.5 inch between those two edges. It's nice for your eye. It's really beautiful view for your eye, so it will be great if you will just fold it. Here it's around 1 inch, this is 1.5, so you will have nice double pocket. And stop talking and we're gonna continue. Otherwise, it will be really very long video. So, now I'm going to make, I think, this side. And I'm going to show you two different styles. What you can do. So, because here I've got both sides, they are writing. I'm gonna choose now that note sheet, music sheet paper. I'm gonna glue it down. Here I'm gonna make like folding pages on this one. So I'm gonna show you how I will make it. Again, scoring board. Oops, sorry. Oh my god, I hope it will not fall down again. Oh my. So, this page. Here I will have spine. I think it will be good if I will put those spines first. Yes, on both sides it will be good. Yeah. So, step back. First, I'm gonna put there my spine. I know I'm making these a little bit different than we normally do or covers for journals, but it doesn't mean it doesn't mean that it's wrong way. As I said before, it's no matter which process you're gonna use, that's important is a result where you're gonna end up. So believe me, it works this way as well. I'm gonna use cardstock, a little bit heavier cardstock for this one. I've got here brown cardstock somewhere. If I didn't lost it. No. I've got here heavy brown cardstock, so I'm gonna use that. And I've got prepared one, this strip with double-sided tape. I'm gonna cut out this one as well. It's a little bit deeper, which is brilliant, and I'm going to show you and explain you. Hopefully, it will cut. Yes, good. So I've got those two strips where I've got already my double-sided tape. For one side, I'm gonna use a strip 1/2 inch deep. For that other side, this strip is 3/4 inch wide strip. And why I'm using it, when you're folding your pages, one side will be inside and that other side have to be over that other side, that first side. So, which means that spine on that second going page, oh my god, my explanation will be horrible, but hopefully you will understand what I mean. That spine on that second page will be a little bit deeper, a little bit bigger, to make sure that you will have here space for everything. And then this one will be not like bulky. It will just nicely lie down. Oh my god. I'm sorry for my explanation. Oh wow. I'm gonna show you here. Here I'm still missing papers. So if I will put inside papers here, and here will be same spine like here. Here it's a little bit smaller than here on this side. So if I will place there my papers, this is too big. Sacre-bleu! Oh my god. Then I will fold it, and this, if this side will be same, like on this side, that's fine. This one will be like, not laying down properly, but it will be like bulky, too bulky, and it will fly in the air. So, it depends which side you wanna fold first. There, put a little bit smaller, little bit thinner spine. If you wanna fold this first, and then this side, put on this side bigger spine, and here smaller, because this will be first one. You don't have to have there a bigger spine. So I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna fold this one like first. So I'm gonna cut it right here. I forgot to make it right leg. I'm gonna glue it down. I hope this video will be not too long, because then it can be so boring. Now we're gonna glue this one. Okay. Mark and cut. I think in movies they are saying, and cut. Yeah, we make a movie. Okay, glue it down. You can use your distress ink. Here I'm gonna use my distress ink. A little bit, not too much. I hope I'm still in view. I have to learn how to do the live streaming. And also I'm waiting for a new laptop. We just found that processing memory in my laptop here, it's not too big, so I can't I can't put two videos together, because that processor it's not getting there. It's stuck and it doesn't work. It's a brilliant laptop. It's a really good laptop. It's new from my son. But that memory, it's too small for processing video, so I'm waiting for a new one. But until that, I'm gonna try to make videos somehow like this without falling this front of me. Okay, now I'm going to take that music note paper. This is prepared in the middle with that masking tape. I'm gonna take my scoring board and I'm gonna show you how you can put your pages inside. Now we're gonna measure. Now I can show you why I was explaining you how to place this duct tape or some strong tape. Here is that back cover, here is that spine, and I still have a piece of that duct tape on that front, which means that even if it will be folding here many times, it will still hold all together. That's why I was telling you that. Thirds, thank you so much, David. For all those words, it's amazing that you're helping me. So to split them on those thirds and use them this way, and you will have still a bit of that strong tape on your page or cover here. So this page from here to the spine has a nearly 6 inches. Okay, so I'm gonna where I place it. Come on, Evie. I already lost my scoring tool. Did I? Oh, see? I already lost my scoring tool. Oh, here. Okay, I got it. Oh my god. I'm gonna make scoring lines. Because I'm gonna use mostly those tags. Those tags are 3 and 1/8. So I'm gonna make scoring lines and 4, then 8, 4 and 8, and that's it. And I'm gonna make, because I'm gonna show you that other way, so I'm gonna make same scoring lines, 4 and 8 on both pages, and I'm gonna show you how you can use them, 4 and 8. Okay. And I'm going to show you how you can use those pages. It's 4 inches and 8 inches. And before, I'm gonna glue them to the lap book. Make sure even those folds, you're gonna make them a little bit stronger, because this is very old paper and it's not strong enough to hold all those foldings, so make sure you're gonna make it stronger to protect it from falling apart. I'm gonna use this Tim Holtz washi tape. Come on. Okay, I'm gonna use this Tim Holtz washi tape. Here. Nope, 4 and 8. All right. This is the first one. I'm gonna protect this other one as well. 4 and 8. Folding, okay. Protect these folds first. Okay. Protect these folds, which will give you some chance that your pages will hold together. So we've got same folding, and now I'm going to show you. This is gonna be first, and here I wanna have some kind of openings pages. So I've got folds like this. Don't mind about this one. This is that middle of previews that pages, but you've got fold like this, like Z. And I wanna have some kind of opening. So I'm gonna use this longer edge for glue it down on this bottom part. I'm gonna use, again, double-sided tape to give me kind of strongness. And I'm gonna glue it down. Fold it. You can use your scoring board and score it with your scoring board and make line, and then use some liquid glue. So I've got this Z, and here I've got that fold, and now I'm going to fold it down. I'm going to fold this down and glue it on that edge on my page. And now it's totally up to you if you will left these pages inside, or you can fold it that opposite way first and this second, and now we can start to decorate it. We will have this opening, so it will have page here, page here, page here, and page here. I'm gonna try to decorate it somehow. We're gonna make some beautiful tops. We're gonna put there some these envelopes, and we will see where we will end up. I'm gonna take some beautiful strong paper. This is from other book, and it has print and some photography. And I'm gonna use it here on the top. Yeah, it's brilliant size. So I'm gonna use here this my template with those two pockets. I'm gonna draw it down, but before I will put it, I'm gonna use that masking tape. Or no, here I'm gonna use, I think, pardon me, here I'm gonna use some washi tape. Sorry for my head. I'm so very sorry that I'm getting that again. Here I'm gonna use this washi tape. It will make also beautiful decoration, I think. I'm gonna use this washi tape, and I'm gonna make two layers. I'm gonna draw from that other side. I'm gonna draw those kind of pockets. I'm gonna place it like in the middle, hopefully. Like this. Pencil. Draw these pockets. If you got any punch for this one or any dye which will make this job for you, just use it. But I don't have dyes like this which will make this cutting. So that's why I made the template, and I don't mind that I have to use my scissors. So I'm gonna cut it out. Those two pieces. Okay. You can save this one, and then you can make with this some kind of embellishment using those pieces. So don't throw it away. On this journal I'm using distress ink, so I'm gonna use it here as well. And I think I'm gonna use also corner punch, because I like those curvy corners. So I'm gonna use it on all pages here. Even those basic pages. I'm gonna cut them down. Cut also these, because I wanna have that soft look. Okay, and here we will do it a little bit later, but here I can do it immediately right now. I don't mind. Good. And come on, go there. Good. Okay. So we will have pocket here. I'm gonna use that distress ink. I'm gonna distress a little bit. I'm sorry. These pockets. Yeah, come on. I think I need new one. It's totally dry, probably. Yay. Or it's in shock, like me, from that huge rumor, and my shelling fall apart. I will try to upload that short video. It's really, I'm gonna cut it. I'm not gonna leave it all of that, but. It's so funny to see, like, oh my god, and now it's dark, because my camera is somewhere under my shelving. Okay. Oops. Come on. And a little bit of black around. Not too much, just a little bit of black around. Okay. And we're gonna glue it down, and we will... Beautiful pocket here. But before, oh my god, Evie, I'm gonna use that distress ink also here. See? Okay. And I need a little bit of brown color on this edge. Okay, finally. Good, good, good. So I'm gonna use this tacky glue. And here we will have pockets. So I'm gonna use the tacky glue all around. Come on. No. Aha, maybe I'm not gonna use my tacky glue all around. Oh god. Why? Why isn't doesn't going right away? Come on. Go. No. Go. Good boy. Good, good. Okay. We're gonna... I put glue also here between those two pockets. So now I can glue it down. Good. I'm sorry, pardon me. Okay. It's this one. Let it dry. Fold it over. And we need to make this a little bit stronger. So here, what we can make here. Sip a little bit of my tea. Oh, here we can make those pockets for tacks. Yes. Okay, we're gonna make pockets for tacks. I'm gonna use this my clocking card because they've got nice. This is like Manila cardstock. It's not too heavy, but it's nice thickness, just right for work like this. I'm gonna measure this one. Oh, it should be how much? 4. Yes, 4 inches. We made it 4 inches. Oh, sorry. Pardon me. I'm gonna show you. This I learned from Katy Orta's channel, how she's making, she call it that t-shirt pockets, and it's very clever and it's really nice. So I'm gonna show you what she's doing. It's 4 inches deep, this fold, 4 inches deep, this one. Same, it's from that other side. So I need 4 inches, maximum 4 inches pockets. I'm gonna make them 3 3/4 those pockets, and because I like to use 1/2 inch those folds inside, I need cut pieces. 3 3/4 will be pocket plus 1 inch for those folds, which means 4 3/4 pieces. So I'm gonna make how many of them? 4. I'm gonna make 4 of them. This clocking card, it's deep 3 1/4. So I've got piece of cardstock 3 1/4 and 4 4 3/4, like my basic. I'm gonna make, I think, 4 of them. Same way. One, two, three, four. Four, four. No. Come on. Okay. So we cut our cardstock. Now I'm going to score those folds which will be inside, half an inch from both sides. Oh, come on, Evie. Half and half over here. Half and half, same as here, half one side, half other side, half and half. Okay, I've got four. Those pieces with scoring half an inch from those sides. Fold them, all of them. And now one will be like my basic bottom pocket. It will be here. So I'm gonna use corner punch on those bottom corners, because I like to have it like decorative part as well. Also, I'm gonna distress it again a little bit. The page. Sorry, chaotic. Oh God. Distress my pages. And I'm going to, so we've got first pocket, and I'm going to glue it down with the first one. Yes, it will be like this. I'm gonna use wet glue, this sticky glue. I'm gonna put glue on my folds. And also here on the bottom, some amount of glue. Glue it down. And now I'm going to show you what you have to make with those t-shirt pocket. It's very clever and very funny, and I really like these pockets because they are kinda easy, I can say. They are not too hard to make, and a really clever idea. And she has these other pieces. She's making measurement from the top. It depends how far or how big gap you wanna have between your pockets. So here I think I'm gonna have that 1 inch, around 1 inch. So if I will take it by my eye, it means that I'm gonna cut that fold here. And then, you know, I've got those lines, which is good for me. I'm gonna use those lines. And from here, I'm gonna cut like in this shape. That paper, same it will be from opposite way, from that opposite side. And same position and some kind of... So you're gonna end up with something like this. Now, fold this one inside. Put your glue on these flaps. And I'm also using, double-sided tape on that bottom part to make sure that my tacks will stop in some position. I'm gonna use this, I think it's 1/4 inch double-sided tape. Sorry for my head if I am in your view. I'm sorry. I think I am in it. I'm sorry. Put your double-sided tape inside, and now, like, slide it inside until those folds will stop you, and glue it down. And same way, continue with all of them. Make sure you've got same gap. Mark same gap here. So I'm gonna cut it again under that line. Not straight, but a little bit in that shape. Same from that opposite side. And kind of that. It's like panties. Here I'm placing double-sided tape, and I tried before to put there liquid glue. But when I slide it inside, that liquid glue was all over the page, so all my pocket was glued down. So that's why I'm using double-sided tape here. And on those folds, I'm using liquid glue. Put that liquid glue. Here. Oh, come on. Ouch. Go there. Gosh. Okay. And again, slide it in until your folds will stop you. Glue it down. I'm not sure where it's ending, so that's why I'm going all over. Okay. And here that last one. And again, at the same position. Just cut it down, and as you can see, it's very easy pocket, very clever pocket, and it's not giving you some kind of bulky view. It's really nice and flat and strong. Oh, here, okay, here, again, here double-sided tape. Side of tape here, glue, and slide it in and stop. Those folds will always stop you at same position, so it's really good. Oh, or Sam is snoring. So now I can show you. You've got pocket, which will stop you here. You've got pocket. See? Like beautiful cascade. So we've got here pockets. This one is gonna be like first fold. We've got this one, it will be like second. And don't be afraid that it will not look beautiful. We will get there. Don't worry, we will get there. It's still in process. It's still waiting for that special. Now we've got this one. And because I like those tabs, I'm thinking to do here what I made before. I'm gonna show you what I made before in one I find it. In here, in here.
I can't show you because I don't know what to... Oh, yeah.
We got here this one. It's not finished yet as well. But as you can see, it has also so many pockets. And here, I have this tab on this page. But when you open it, you can see that. Because here it's same tab on that opposite page. So I'm gonna show you how you can make this one. To make it, those two pages a little bit stronger, it's good if you're gonna use...
My son Jacob is here again. He's dancing around.
Lovely that. Look at that.
Yeah. I'm gonna use this box from Pizza for my tops, flaps. I need... It's from here to here. I'm gonna measure how big two sides I'm gonna need. I'm gonna measure this. From here to here it's 8 1/4 inch. Okay, I'm gonna cut piece down. 8 1/4. This is really brilliant machine. It's totally amazing tool. Oops. Oh. Come on. No. Stay. I'm sorry. I think I hit with my head the camera. So I'm sorry if I made you feel. Oops. 8 1/4. I'm gonna put that down. And now I need to know how large this is. 10 inches. Okay, I need to make it a little bit smaller. 10 inches. I'm gonna make 9 3/4 the height of my pages. So here I've got basic for those two flaps or tabs. This is the basic. It's like this. It will fill those two pages. Now what I need, I'm gonna leave one page with this nice brown color, but the other one I need to cover with something. I need to use some beautiful book page, so I'm gonna use this double-sided tape again. I'm gonna cover this this, what is it, carton cereali box. Oh my god, cereali box with book page to make it nice and pretty. No, come on. I'm so sorry. I need a small piece. Tape here. I hope that this is not too long. It is in a... But I'm trying to go as much fast as I can. Are you prepared for your New Year's Eve? I'm probably not too much. I have loads of to do. Hopefully I will get there. Hopefully I will prepare myself soon. I think I'm gonna use those beautiful postmark pages. So I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna glue it down this way. You know, when I'm trying to glue it down that opposite way, that paper placed on my already prepared cardboard, cardstock, it's sometimes that book page paper, it's like a flying in the air and then it's stuck with those folds and it's not nice. So this way, it's mostly nicer and more clean. Gluing. Okay, oops. No, oops. Oops. Come on. Good. Yeah, I think I can take smaller. You know, I've got scissors for my nails. Those shears, teeny tiny small, I can take them. No, that's because of that fault, shall we? I still can't believe that it was fall down. It was so horrible. So surprised me. And I sweat a little bit. I'm not sure if you already saw that, but if you already saw that, you heard that. But I sweat a little bit. Because all those filigrees was all over here. Hey, here. You got Canada. Yay. Hello. Hello, Canada. Okay. Oh, I was so surprised how many people from Europe, from Denmark, from Nederland, from Finland, from Holland. I've got like my subscribers. I'm so happy with that. Thank you so much, girls. Thank you so very much. I didn't know that I've got so many subscribers from Europe as well. I know about girls from from Canada. Here you are, girls. I know about girls from America. And also I know about my lovely Elena from Spain and Despina from Greece. Hi, girls! But I didn't know that I've got so many from Germany. From Germany! Oh my God! And I've been studying Germany for 3 years, but because I never used that language, only I know it's, oh my God, as entschuldigen Sie mich bitte, or entschuldigen Sie mich bitte, and yet, then something that I forgot my school, the homework, that's that I don't remember, but I think, if I will start to read some book or listen some book, maybe I will get there again. So, now back to that project. I've got prepared that basic of those two pages. And now I want to have that fold. One side will be on this side, and that fold, that tab, will be like sneaking peeking in the air. Which means that I'm going to make my template a little bit. Here is ending that page. Here is ending this page. So I'm going to make my fold just right there. Like this, I'm gonna draw it down. Here is ending a little bit more. Here. Show me. Yes. Here. Here is ending this page. Here is ending. And where is it here? Here. Here is ending that page and here is ending that page. Like this. Okay. Now I'm gonna draw it down. The template. Okay. I'm gonna cut it out and we will see. Again, these small scissors are mine. Good. I'm gonna make a little bit soft that corner. Also, I'm gonna use it for all those others. Here, those others. I'm gonna use distress ink again. Distress all those edges. And of course you can work with your folders. Why not? Do it from your folders and it will be much more easy. You've got already your tabs. So then you can just decorate it. I wanted to try it from those book pages and if is it possible and how it will look like. Because I felt in love with this, so I'm still continuing. So we will have here two pockets. I think I will need a little bit put down this page. Oh, maybe not. Maybe it will be just enough. Yes. So I'm going to glue down this first. And I'm going to use my tacky glue. And you don't have to be worried that those tags will stuck because you can always take them out. You know, when you will have inside some tags or cards, you can take it off and then open it. It's like this. And now the other side. Oh, come on. Oh. You know, it's good tacky glue, but I think it's already done. So it's too thick. And now we're gonna place it here, like this, good, like this. And let it dry. You can also decorate the top. Here we can place some small envelope. I'm gonna have a look what I've got here. So I can place here a small envelope. Oh, this is too big. I've got here a small envelope, so I can place it here and make it like embellishment. Also, I've got prepared few of these pockets. They are very easy pockets. It's just, oh my god, it's not square, it's rectangle. Is it rectangle? Triangle, it's triangle, like Bermuda triangle. But rectangle, it's that long one, is it? I'm not sure if I remember that right. It's like long square. But this is something like long square, longer square, with that half circle. So I've got prepared few of them. So you can place here that envelope and here that pocket. And tuck, which will be placed inside, will be like closure for your envelope. Or you can make there some closing. Also here you can place this pocket. You can have there tuck. So I'm gonna let it dry. Because these are cards, so they need a little bit more for drying. See? Now we've got shown that part of that folder, that tab. And it's already like embellishment, even I don't have there any tags yet. So I'm gonna let it dry, this one. And I'm not sure how long it is. I think it's too long already. I can't see there. It's not? Huh, it doesn't look too long. I'm gonna let it dry and I'm gonna show you from same folding page. Still we've got that same folding page like we did before. And I'm gonna show you how different way you can glue it down. I'm gonna do it on this when we started together. So we've got page, which I scored 4, 8, and I left that rest. And I scored it at that 4 because then I can place there pocket, which will hold my tags from that Tim Holtz. That was my count of my measurement. Okay, so that's why I scored it that 4, which is bigger than pocket for that those tags. So here we've got this one, and I'm gonna leave it in this folding. Yes, I'm gonna use this corner punch again. I'm gonna cut these corners because I like that softness. You don't have to do it, you know. But I like that softness, so I'm gonna cut all these corners. Circle, not circle, no. Corner. Okay. And I'm gonna glue it down. First, again, I have to do sponge. Here, I nearly made mistake, so I'm gonna take my cardstock, this one, and I'm gonna prepare my sponge. I'm gonna glue this. And I'm gonna cut 2 strips again. I'm gonna cut 2 strips. One will be 1/2 inch. One going to be 1/2 inch. And that other one, 1/2 inch. Come on, come on, come on, come on. This. Hopefully it was good. Yes. Oh, sorry. 1/2 inch. It will be that smaller spine. And that other will be 3/4. I'm guessing it's enough. I put my spines. Just a minute, I'm gonna sip. I'm sorry. I can't see how many we've got. Hopefully it's still some space there. Okay, we've got those two spines. I'm gonna close this like a first, maybe yes. So here I'm gonna make no, I'm gonna continue with here to have smaller spine where I will probably place my papers as well. So I'm gonna use a little bit of black soot, just a little bit. This will be journal where I don't wanna use so much this as distress ink. I wanna kinda have it in that natural colors without distressing too much. So I'm gonna glue this down. I hope I am in view. Am I? Come on. Don't go down. I'm gonna glue it this time. This? Am I in view? Again. You got a big head. And here I'm gonna place this one. Distress it a little bit. Take off the tape. Oops. Take it off. Take no. Later. Come on. Go down. Ah. Somehow doesn't work with me. Okay. Yay! Got it. Okay, so now we know where our cover is starting. So I'm gonna glue this. Here it's our folding. It's four, and that rest. So I'm gonna glue this down like my pocket. I'm gonna use this one like my pocket. So I'm gonna glue it in those three sides. I'm not sure if I will, maybe make it stronger a little bit. I will hope it will hold. I hope it will hold properly. So I'm gonna glue it down. So once again, I made two scoring lines, which gave me two similar sides, similar folds, but then one was a little bit bigger. That bigger one I'm gonna use like my pocket. Looks like this. And I'm gonna glue it down like this. Glue it down here. I placed that glue. So now here we've got pocket. It still needs to dry. And here we've got two pages which will be open. So we can start to decorate that bottom one. And I'm gonna start with some envelope, I think. Where I played everything. It was running somewhere. Where I place it? Oh, I got it. Finally. You know what is horrible? When you have something in your hands and then you place it somewhere and it gets lost. So here, I think. Here, I think I'm gonna use this. Yes. This envelope. This is coin envelope. So I'm gonna use this envelope and also maybe some bigger part behind, and I'm gonna make just two pockets, like slide pockets. Those still drying, come on, it's still drying. Or I can place two of those pockets here. Oh, I can make it this way. I can make it this way. And it will fold. That will be nice. Show me. It will be exactly. This one. Okay. I'm gonna place these here. Right. Okay. So I'm gonna use those two envelopes like my pockets here. And also, I'm gonna glue them down way where I will have also a pocket from the top. Which means here I will have pocket from envelopes. Here and here. And because I'm gonna put glue, like this, and I'm gonna put glue on these three sides, it will give me also a pocket from here, and I will make same with this one. Okay, we're gonna glue it down. I'm going to glue it down here. And I'm gonna glue it down here. Okay, three pockets. This. Okay, I'm gonna let it dry. And I'm gonna prepare something to put there. Oops. I'm gonna measure this one. That envelope is 10.5 centimeters. I believe I got their spot 9 centimeters inside, which is how many? 3.5 inches maximum inside, I think. So I'm gonna prepare some tacks, probably place them there, and I'm going to show you what you can do. Not tags, maybe I will do something different. I can do, oh no, but I can do. It was 3.5, so I'm gonna have a look. Okay. 3.5, 3.5, 3.5. I'm gonna give it a try. If 3.5, it will fit inside. I'm gonna give it a try. So a little bit less. My fault. This is a little bit less. That other part, it's a little bit less. Yeah, and this is coming, going. Yes, it's going well. And it's going well here as well. Okay. So I'm gonna use this wideness, or what is it? Deepness. And it's 3 1/8. I'm gonna do this one same way. 3 1/8. I'm gonna show you beautiful insert. This is long 6 5/8. Oh no, 8 5/8. Oh my god, sorry. 8 5/8. It's long, those two strips. And I would like to have some kind of insert in those pockets. Those pockets are deep. They will be probably both same. So I'm gonna. It's maximum. Okay. Three and one quarter deep. So I'm gonna fold these. This is 4 4. Okay, 3 1/4. I'm gonna fold it in 3 1/2. No, I'm gonna fold it in 3 3/4 and 7 1/2, 3 3/4 and 7 1/2, and again 3 3/4 and 7 1/2. No, come on, Peter. So we've got, once again, we've got strip 3 1/8 deep, sorry, no, and long, oh my god, long 8 5/8, and I score it, and 3 3/4 and 7 1/2, and I'm going to show you what you can do with this. It will be nice insert. If you've got leftovers of your coffee dyed paper, you've got maybe some small bits and pieces, you've got them here, you've got loads of bits and pieces and separate tags, like this. All this, you've got here, I'm sorry. I'm going to show you what you can do with those bits and pieces and how you can make beautiful inserts. I'm gonna put those corners again. Also on that other one. This. sorry. Okay, I don't need here too much distressing. So I'm going to go just those edges a little bit. Okay. okay, here as well, just a little bit those edges, not too much. Okay, and now here, oh, we are nearly there. See, oh, I am totally there. Okay, I'm just gonna cut those corners, and I'm gonna use this. This is left over from some other work, and it's exactly the same size I need here, which is brilliant. That's totally cool. I'm gonna place it inside because it will be my journaling spot. And same way, if you will put your papers you've got all around, even small quotes. You can make beautiful decorative element, beautiful space for journaling. Same way, I will continue here. Large. I'm gonna put this down. This, cut the corners, and don't be worried that you don't have full piece for your page, because still you can make it like a pretty page. Maybe you've got some leftovers with sheets, some leftovers with embellishments like this one. So I'm gonna use it here. I'm gonna go down here. Put this, oops, come on. This, so we've got inside, and now we need to do this side. So I'm gonna use these. This is nearly. I think it's a piece like this. I need to get there some glue. Again.